This video is brought to you by G2A.com.
Hello ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Martinez 210 here today. Welcome to another video. Today in this video, I'm going to be not only giving my own, I wouldn't say personal review because I have not played this yet, but I am going to be showing y'all guys an installation guide to LCPDFR, which is a mod for GTA 5, pretty much a mod that allows you to be a police officer. So I'm going to be showing y'all guys that, and just pretty much the whole entire installation process. So just give me one moment. I need to grab, where is it? It was in my history. I do need WinRAR. Also DL. I will be putting all the links down below in the description of pretty much all the stuff that y'all guys need in order to play this and download it and all that stuff. Where is it? It is right here. Okay, so to start off with, what y'all guys are originally gonna need is WinRAR. If y'all guys are curious how to get that, you just go to this website right here and then you select pretty much what computer you are. I'm a 64-bit, so I'm gonna click on that. And then once I click on that, it'll pretty much install. I don't need this considering I have it installed already, so I'm gonna clear those two out. And once you're done with WinRAR, it basically, you just install it, go through all the process, and pretty much once you're done installing it, it lets you open your files. So I'm pretty sure y'all guys can use any other file opener, but I like using WinRAR. So there's that. The next thing that y'all guys are gonna need is the main mod in general. Now you guys can install many mods through this, like vehicle mods and textures and stuff like that for the police DLC mod, whatever y'all want to call this. But that's all y'all guys are gonna do is click on this one, and then this is gonna pop up. You wanna click on that one. And hold on. Okay, sorry guys. And then from here, y'all guys are gonna click on the green little download this file. You're gonna click on that, click on agree and download. And then from here, y'all guys can install any one of these. I mean, well, y'all guys can install both of these if y'all guys would like. Or even just this one and this one, because this is the manual. I have no idea what this one is, but this is the one you're gonna need. So you click download, and then from there it'll take you to this page, I am not a robot, and then download. And then from there it'll wait, it says it'll take a few seconds, and then from there it'll start installing. Again, I don't need that, so I'm gonna go ahead and clear that, and we are done with this page. Now onto the next page. This one is pretty much a installer, which I'm going to show y'all guys real quick, the main mod process, and then I'll show y'all guys that website. So pretty much when you get in, your mod for GTA 5, your mod, by the way, after you install WinRAR, it'll have the little books and it'll say this right here. Mine is in its own little folder because I put it there, but most likely y'all's will end up in the download section. But you just want to find anywhere where your downloads went. But anyways guys, y'all want to go ahead and find the LCPDFR, and then this is the main file. This will be in there. You want to go ahead and drag this to your desktop, and when you drag it, it'll look like this. And then from here, what y'all guys are gonna want to do, you're gonna want to double click that, and then I don't know if y'all guys are seeing this part. I have not tested if it records this part, but pretty much you'll get a little thing saying like, oh, are you sure you want this program to have access to your computer? And you just click yes, and then from there it'll load this up. and then you select what you are or what you want, I guess you could say. You go ahead and click OK. And then from there, it should take a while to load up. So while that's loading up, I'll be back. Alrighty guys, so it loaded up. It really didn't take that long. It's just midway, I had a yawn. So yeah. Anyways, so this will pop up. You wanna go ahead and click next, agree. Make sure all this is clicked just like mine. And then you wanna click next. You wanna make sure that it goes to your Steam folder, wherever you have GTA really, but mine is from Steam. So it'll say like where my Steam is, and it'll Steam apps, common, and then GTA 5. Pretty much where anywhere where your game files are located, that's where you want this to go. So from there, you want to click next, and then it's going to extract all these files into your folder, and then you want to make sure this is clicked. Click finish, and then this will take a while, and then from here, it's going to pop up another folder. And then from right here, that's all y'all guys want to do is, it'll say this right here. And then from there, you want to click next, show license. And then from here, this will count down 4, 3, 2, 1, and then click accept. And then from here, that'll check. Now this part right here is basically saying that we recommend these settings. So you can either click to do your own setting and disable those settings by yourself, or you can just have it do it for you. It's the easiest, so I'm just gonna do that. And then from there, you want to click this little check mark right there on that box. This, you want to leave it alone, and then you want to click save. So that's pretty much that, guys. From there, what you're gonna want to do, I have a shortcut for my GTA 5 like files. So there's this. So pretty much you're gonna have all these little files that got added. If y'all guys are curious what this is, basically when you load GTA, you can play single player, but whenever you try to load online, it will pretty much, like, I guess you could say, crash the game or whatever. It's because Rockstar doesn't want you to go into online with mods. So what you're probably gonna have to do, there's many different ways. You could probably just take them out little by little, but I'd rather just install it again. It's really not that long of a process, but if you just want to uninstall, just go ahead and click this one right here, and then it'll take out every single file that LSPDR installed. But other than that, guys, pretty much to launch the game, if it works for y'all, then great, you won't need that other file that we installed earlier. But just in case, I will go ahead and show y'all guys. I need the file. And this is what I'm talking about. This is my current game version. Doesn't support this. I don't know, maybe y'all's will. But if it doesn't, just like mine won't, then this is where the second link comes in handy. And this is, we can exit out of that if that pops up. But you want to go ahead and go to this link, which is the Rage plugin in Hook. You want to go to downloads. And then from downloads, most likely this won't be clickable through any of these versions because they're no longer available. But just in case they are, just know this, that you gotta grab this one. And let's just say y'all guys are watching this video later on down the road, pretty much just install the newest version of the plugin or whatever this you want to call this, because they pretty much update the little folders each time, I guess you could say, GTA gets out of date with these folders. But anyways, you're just gonna wanna go ahead and click on the newest one. In my case, it's that one. And I'm gonna click cancel because I already have that one. And I'm gonna get rid of that. And that's pretty much it. From there, your folder will end up, where did I put mine? Ah, mine's up here. Okay, so from there, you wanna double click on that. And then it'll open all these files up. Now, if y'all want, y'all guys can read it by yourself. This will pretty much teach y'all how to install it, but I do not need that considering I've done it so many times that, and well, that's pretty much the main reason why. But if y'all guys are curious about the installation section, it's right here. Pretty much you just put every single file that's over here into your game files, which is these game files. You want to throw every single one of these files into there, except for two, and that is the SDK, which is this one, and the license, which is that one. So, other than that, that's pretty much it. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys that. Let me drag this right here. And what you're going to want to do is just grab plugins. You're going to want to drop that off over here. And then you want to highlight all these. Do not put the README file in there. Just kind of skip that one. If it pops this up, just replace it. Because it's pretty much saying that it's the old files. This is the updated one. And anytime you launch it and it says that it's out of date, just go ahead, re-download it. Complete this whole entire process. Unless there's another README file, just kind of double check, make sure that it's still the same way, to pretty much drop that off in there. But anyways, so I skipped these two, so I'm gonna go ahead and drop these off in there too. Replace and let this load up. We're gonna go ahead and close that, and then we're gonna reopen the shortcut so that way everything has updated. And then from there you want to click the Rage plugin hook. So let me go ahead and do that real quick. Okay, and yes guys, I know I didn't do it. It's just every time I feel like I'm about to yawn, I'm just like, let me go do that. Anyways, so this is the updated one. It will open up like this. You want to accept it, and then from there it'll go into all your files, make sure everything is updated, and then it should go through just like this. And you'll know if you did it right because it says save and launch. But just to double check, my suggestion is to actually launch the game and find out. Now this is your console key. Basically you click that key to open up the mod. So I actually have a mod menu, and the way I open that is F4, and I have another one that you click it and that one's F8. So considering I already have one, I'm gonna go ahead and click F5. And then you want to leave all this alone. You can always change this console key. That's the only thing I would recommend changing out. But other than that, you want to make sure plugins is just like this. And then advanced, you want to have everything unchecked. And then leave all this alone. And then from there, you want to click save and launch. And then this will pop up. Click OK. And then you'll pretty much see this open up. It's a little launcher for the plugin. But from there, it should open up the game. And let's see. And waiting for game window. And there we go. So it is actually launching the game. Let me just fix this window like that. But guys, this is extremely easy to install. I had trouble, I guess you could say, at first, but after so many times of doing it, it was extremely easy. It was really, really easy. After a while, it just gets easier and easier. I'm going to definitely be doing more tutorials on how to install a certain mod. You'll know if it worked because it'll also pop up this. And then in the corner, it'll say loading in story mode with Rage plugin. But other than that, guys, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna go ahead and let this game load up. And once I'm in game, I will be right back. Alrighty, guys. So automatically,
man, I feel like crap.
You'll see the little things in the corner. And that's how you'll know if it was successfully installed. Plus, it'll say, welcome to the Rage plugin, so on and so forth. And, yeah, guys, so as you can see, it's fully installed. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how it works. I'm actually going to go ahead and do a, I guess you could say, a type of Let's Play for all the mods I install that involve stuff like this. So, I guess you could say this is going to be, like, the first half of a Let's Play. But to go ahead and start off, let's go ahead and click F5. And then from here, you want to click uppercase F, lowercase O-R-C-E, and then from there, okay, it does it lowercase anyway. So, force, and then you want to click duty, and then enter, and then from there, what you're going to want to do is exit out of that, And then from there, it'll say you are now on duty. So we're going to go ahead and get inside of our car. The location of the police station is this right here. It'll say police guard, garage, and police station. There's actually multiple police stations that you can go to. One right there, one over here. Pretty much just all the police stations possible. But we're going to go ahead and go to the nearest one. And that one, actually, we're going to go to this one. Is it that one? Yeah, the one with the garage. So we're actually going to go ahead and go to that one. Let's see. I'm still new to freaking PC, guys. So this is kind of new to me, the whole clicking and doing and all that. Yeah, definitely gonna have to have my music off. Oh, I'm sorry, people. Anyways, guys, let me go ahead and get there, and I will be right back. Alrighty, guys, so I am back. Freaking running me over and stuff, guys. What's up with that? Anyways, so I am here. Pretty much I'm already on duty, but to go ahead and actually get my police uniform and all that stuff, you go to any police station. This is the police garage. But let me go ahead and go into the police station. And that is the main entrance, I believe. I can go through the main entrance, right? Ah, that's cool. Get armor and stuff. Okay, so it's actually downstairs. You could go through that entrance. Where is it? Is it over here? It is over here, I think.
I hope we don't have any more budget cuts.
Indeed.
Oh, this is actually the one for the sales. Where?
Oh, man.
Hey. I wonder what happens if I just go off shooting cops, like, curious about that.
Attention all units.
If you wish to respond to dispatch, press Y to
enter. Okay.
Well, I would respond to that, but I'm still trying to find the freaking entrance thingy here. Can I not find it? Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna go ahead and go to another one, guys. So, but I can actually take a police car, I believe, without getting in trouble.
Officers report a criminal resisting arrest on.
Okay. Yep, I can. So I'm gonna take this police bike, and I'm gonna go to the one that's over here. I would go ahead and just pause the video, but it is not that far, so I'm gonna go ahead and go over there. Let's see. I gotta say, guys, this mod is extremely cool to me.
Just take it, he's through the door anyway.
Hey.
Help!
Sir!
That bastard just robbed me!
Duh. Sir.
Don't make this any worse than it already is.
Sir, drop the weapon. Never mind.
Tell me it's good news.
Thought you might need this.
What a gentleman. And for once, I'm not being sarcastic.
You're welcome, ma'am. Sure, I'll save that. Okay, well, I need to get back to my police bike and resume my duties of being a police officer. And that is up here. So right there, and now we can continue. I think it's pretty cool though, because like you can respond to things. Like, I know that was always a thing where you go ahead and help a random freaking citizen But other than that, I mean, there's other stuff, like you could respond to people breaking into houses or robbing banks, robbing a convenience store, just different stuff. Which, speaking of that, not only can we be a policeman, but there's actually another mod that I would like to install. You just hit a police officer!
Yo, this is bullshit!
You fucker!
Hey, get out of the vehicle! No? Alright, I'm not even gonna chase you, I'm too busy. I'm making a video. But there's one mod that's pretty much you crack a safe. Which I think is pretty cool. But for this one, I know you just go inside. Oops, I hit the wrong key. So to enter the police station, so to go off duty, you click E. But I think to enter the police station, you also hit E. I think I just got off duty. Yeah, I'm no longer on duty. But let me go back into duty. And then I can actually become a real police officer. Which, another thing is, really, you can have two different mods going on. I think it's cool because I can have this mod going on. But I can also have another mod, which, this mod menu that I have, I can actually become a police officer and stuff, which I think is pretty cool. But you have different ones. I think this is also pretty cool. You can also, you can be LSPD, you can be LSSD, which that's Los Santos Police Department, and that's Los Santos Sheriff Department, and then you got SAPD, which is I forgot what the other part is. It's more upwards. But you also got that one. And then you got this one too. And then you got this one. This one. You can be a noose if you really want to. FBI. Or FIB, sorry. IAA. And DOA. NYSP. Which is North Yankton, actually. So I think that's pretty cool. But we're going to be LSPD. Just saying though, whatever you select, that's where you pretty much, that's pretty much where you serve, I guess you could say. That's your district. But you male or female, you get your different types of face that you can have. So I'm gonna go with zero, my tops. I kinda like that. My accessories, I'm gonna go with that. Yeah, I think that looks better. Gear. I can have my gun holstered. What's this? Oh, my ranking. I can have that a thing. I have that. Props. Oh. It says none or random. I think. Yeah, I don't really like the hat anyway. So we're gonna go ahead and click on select and continue. And from here, you get a police cruiser, police buffalo. You get all these different police vehicles. Ooh, police bike, sheriff cruiser, SUV. Oh, that's pretty cool. You get the North Yankton one. You get an undercover one, another undercover, another uncovered. Freaking drive that big thing. What even? What is this? You can have a Hydra? I think we're gonna go with the buffalo. Siren. Extras. What's extras? Doesn't say what extra is. But we're gonna go ahead and continue that. And I am now on duty. So I think we might go do something. For now, I think we're gonna go ahead and patrol the Los Santos. Which I do not know how to put on my horn. Which is great.
Your car is making me wet.
Oh.
Unit
148 in downtown. Alright, let's go. Let's report to this. Which again, I don't know how to turn my sirens, but if you have your siren on, people are just like, oh, let me move out of the way. Do I... I thought there was just something that popped up. I think you can actually go inside the police station and look for something to do, so let's...
Oh, damn!
Let me go do that. I wonder if I have any... No, I don't have an ability. Alright, let me go check. Over there. The last time I was in here, they were just like, oh. Well, you can go do this if you really want to.
Report,
a possible 503 in Strawberry. How do I respond to that? Oh, what did I just do? I keep messing up. Okay, map. This says player. I guess we can respond to that. I think that's where you respond. We'll find out, and if not, then I'll just cut the video and I'll go find out, and then I'll cut it back on. So let's go find out. This is where I respond. Sir, I am a police officer. Do you really want to do this, sir? You know what? We're right here at the police station.
This is a Grand Theft Auto in progress on Olympic Freeway.
The hospital can take care of you since we're right there anyways. Man, every time I get close to there, I want to say that is where you go, but then I'm not too sure. Man, I don't know. Oh, freaking crashed again. I'm gonna actually go inside real quick.
Look out!
I can do whatever I want, I'm a police officer. That.
He's working your life.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
This is America you're in.
Really? I thought
apologize,
we were in Mexico.
Dumbass.
No kidding.
Oh man, I'm so sorry.
Turn around.
Oh, I think I know where to go now.
Unit 240, a criminal resisting arrest in La Mesa.
I think this is where you went. It says locker room. Oh yeah, you go in there. You go on and off duty. Well then.
Whoa, shit!
How you doing?
Wax I wonder if my... I do wonder if that mod menu is available. Let me check.
Citizens reporting
it's available.
A Grand Theft Auto in progress
popped up.
In La Mesa.
I could be a super. Did something. Okay, there we go. I don't know where to go. Every time I go to a response.
The hell?
Going there. Yeah, it seems like it's now only quiet, but I don't know how to respond to thingies. I wonder if they updated controls. Like, if I come over here and check the controls, would they be like, oh, do this and this and this? I don't think they tell you keys, do they? I feel like it would be a lot more easier if I go ahead and put on a controller, so I will be right back, guys. Okay, guys, I am back and I have a controller now. So I feel like it would be a lot more easier. We can look inside now. Oh, see? And it says response. Local patrol unit, state, local SWAT. Oh, that's cool. We can be a SWAT team and, like, I know we could be a SWAT team because I said it earlier, but I didn't know you could go, like, do SWAT stuff.
Attention all units. We have an officer requiring assistance in La Mesa.
Well, where's that at? I wonder what happens if I go to a Franklin mission as a police officer.
We've got an officer requiring assistance.
Code 3, code 2.
We've got a code 99 in La Mesa.
Oh, I'm calling police over here. That's what that's doing. I'm sorry, sir.
Only one here. We can take that if no one else wants it.
Hey, I'm sorry, guys. I'm just gonna let go. You can call them. That's what that does. That means we can respond to stuff like that, though. So apparently code 3 is like major. Okay, there's my police sirens and stuff like that. Why I feel bad. People are like crashing and stuff. Because I... Hey, what's going on over there?
Attention all units, we've got a criminal resisting arrest. And Pillbox Hill. Shots fired. All units respond. Code 99 emergency.
How do I react to those? I always see them pop up, but I can never respond to them. Okay, well, I did notice that for some reason they always pop up whenever I go inside, so maybe that's what I need to do. Put my police car right there, and I'll go respond. If one pops up, hopefully. I wonder what happens if I just go shooting and stuff. Like, what happens if I just go all like cop and just freaking shoot like?
Come on!
Why? What you can do? What you can do? And she hit the door.
No.
Wait, I wonder. Do I have access to other stuff that usually you don't have access to? Like.
All units, we've got a suspect resisting arrest. In La Mesa.
How do you do that? No. No. I did it earlier. I don't know how, but I did it. Well, I'm gonna do this. Don't even care anymore.
Unreal.
Do they not care? They don't care. Alright, let's see what happens if I do it to you. They don't care. What happens if I do this to you?
Units recording at 148 on Olympic Freeway. Shots fired. Code 99. All units respond.
All units, go. I'm not gonna be able to respond in time. Your police vehicle. This is my police vehicle. Well, guys, I'm just gonna go ahead and end it off there. I'm gonna try to mess around with this mod a little bit more. Go ahead and try to figure it out and stuff. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video as well as the whole installation guide and stuff like that. If y'all guys did stay tuned that whole time, much appreciated. And other than that, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please drop a like, comment, subscribe. Check out the last two videos. Check out the links down below. Check out all the social stuff on the bottom and the sponsorships on top. If y'all guys would like to check that out, the links will be down below for those guys too. Other than that, guys, I hope y'all guys enjoyed once more. And I will definitely be doing a series on this. And yeah, guys, I'm going to be doing more mod videos and how to install the mods and stuff like that. But other than that, guys, I will see y'all guys in the next one. Till next time, I'm out. Peace out, everybody. Cue the outro now.
cycles of kiddom, the mind switches gears rapidly.